All right, let's get to our top story this morning. The mastermind behind the state's largest Ponzi scheme wants some years knocked off of his sentence. And today, for the very first time, Tom Petters admitted in court he is guilty of a massive Ponzi scheme. He was sentenced to 50 years in prison. On the stand today, he apologized and said his scheme was robbing Peter to pay Paul. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Kate Renner is joining us live just outside the courthouse in St. Paul with more this morning, Kate.
And this is the first time we've heard Tom Petters actually admit that he took part in orchestrating this $3.6 billion Ponzi scheme. He asked the judge to forgive him, and this was the first time he took responsibility for Minnesota's largest fraud. In the past, he'd always maintained his innocence about this. Now, Petters claimed his defense attorneys never offered him a government plea deal of 30 years before, during, or after his 2009 trial. When asked by his attorney why the court should believe he would have accepted a 30-year cap plea deal, Petters answered through tears, "Your Honor, I was scared. I was scared to death. I kept thinking about my kids being gone from them for the rest of my life. I'm sorry I lied in the courtroom, on the stand. I didn't want any more trial. It's a horrible excuse, but I lied. I'm begging for your forgiveness. I would have taken a 30-year cap to avoid going to trial. As God is my witness, I made a terrible mess of things. I apologize." Petters and his attorney went back and forth on different times Petters would or would not have accepted a plea deal. He said he didn't want to admit guilt in front of his children, but he also said he absolutely would have taken a plea deal. Now, Petters told the judge that his life has come full circle, back to the days as a boy growing up in St. Cloud. He said he thought the world revolved around him and realized that it didn't. Now, the U.S. Attorney's Office will be cross-examining Petters, who's on the stand right now, and this could continue. This hearing could continue until tomorrow. Reporting live in St. Paul, Kate Renner, 5 Eyewitness News.
We will update folks throughout the morning and throughout the day here on 5 Eyewitness News.